Richard and I go back many, many years on the golf course initially. I remember down at a golf course in Kent called Moatlands that is no longer a golf course, unfortunately, but it was a very, very pleasant place to be. And I regularly see Richard there from a distance, knowing that he was the ex-England schoolboy golfer, thinking, oh goodness, he's got to be good. And then I heard somebody say, oh God, don't play with Richard, he takes it far too seriously. You know, and I thought, I like him already. I want to play golf with him.
Over in Holland, who I've never met, and I've been training him for a year, and he's made significant changes over that period to his athleticism. So I always believe that you have to build a foundation, a base first. So you build that stability and robustness of the body before you layer up that intensity. And that's the ethos that I've used with all drivers that I've worked with, progressing them from sort of grassroots all the way up to Formula One, to endure the sort of, you know, constraints.
I put on weight. I felt knackered. I ate for England. I needed to chat to Simon to manage the rest. I was going to the fridge and just eating all the everything I could eat. I was so hungry because of the cycling. I was on the bike for hours every day. Yeah, it was tough, but it was actually a real good insight. I'm not an endurance athlete, as you probably tell. So it went against the grain somewhat, but it got me through February. It was a plus sign.
Did tell you about the time we went running together?
Go on.
You know when I said to you that Richard's like, he's either all
of take off, yes.
When we were on the holiday to France once, I said we were going to go for a run, you know, but Richard just ran 100 metres as quickly as he could and then just went home.
Yeah, he's definitely more of a Usain Bolt than a Mo Farah, let's put it that way.
I a few miles. 100 metres, he's done. Back to the fridge.
But then you go again, right?